Welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is Garrett Ainsworth, the CEO of District Metals Corp. And Garrett, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Good morning, Steve. Thanks for having me.
So we want to talk a little bit about your project, Tomtebo, which is located in a very unique area that has been very underexplored, at least this particular project has been. Before we get into some numbers that were released on historic data, maybe you can talk a little bit about this particular project and just the fact that it hasn't really been explored all that much.
Yeah, well, it's something that's really important to know about Scandinavia is, you know, before the 1990s, foreign companies weren't allowed to come in and, you know, explore, develop, and build mines. It was, very, very socialist, and it was only state-run companies that did the work in Sweden, well, and in Finland and Norway as well. So, a lot of the work that was done, you know, wasn't pushed very hard, and from all the different properties I've seen, not a lot of systematic modern exploration was done. And there's a lot of low-hanging fruit that was left to pick off. And it's very unlike other districts that you would find, like VMS districts in Canada, whereby you go in and you would see multiple surveys done each decade as technology advances. That's not the case in Sweden at all. So it really does provide quite a great opportunity for us coming into this jurisdiction.
Now let's talk about these historic results, because they were extremely high grade and really at shallow depths. Maybe you can share some of the numbers that I'm sure amazed you as well when you first saw them.
Well, absolutely. I mean, this is a big news release for us, and I'm so excited to get it out into the public domain. I mean, it's been a year and a half due diligence process. I mean, not on Tomtebo itself, but I mean, this is why we picked Tomtebo and why it's so exciting, because I haven't come across any other projects where you can come on to it and see that high grade of intervals over good widths, good continuity, and that it's a project in a good jurisdiction. We have looked at some projects in ex-Soviet countries, and you know that's a whole other kind of bag to get into. But I mean, a jurisdiction like Sweden is quite good. So, I mean, today's news release really highlighted the north end of the historic Tomtebo mine. One of the highlight holes was 65001 that had about 4.7 meters of about 1,090 grams per ton silver equivalent, or about 28% zinc equivalent. And so it's very, very silver, zinc, lead rich. And the beauty of it's wide open, you know, long strike and at depth, and never been followed up.
What I found interesting about reading all the particular data itself was the fact that these numbers seemed extremely strong, and even the government not really recognizing the fact that this would be something they could eventually get behind. Are you finding that's changed now, and there really is some great push from the government as well for your project to move forward?
From the permitting side, they're very supportive, and they want these projects to go. But I really don't think Sweden has caught on with a lot of Canadian and Australian companies. There's a few of us in there right now, but given the potential, and the Bergslagen district where we're at has just such large mineralized systems, such as Boliden's Garpenberg mine, which is 25 kilometers to the southeast. I mean, that's one of the largest polymetallic mines in the world, and it's a very productive, low cost zinc mine, but it's actually the silver that's making it so low cost, because there's such a high silver content and other types of these deposits within the region. There's also a very high gold content, and then you've got Lundin Mining that has their zinc Gruven mine that's about 175 kilometers to the south of us. Again, it's a fantastic, very productive underground zinc mine with very good copper and gold credits and silver credits as well.
Last question, Garrett, and that is, I want to pick up on something you said a little bit earlier, that usually throughout the decades, they do a lot of the modern exploration work as new technologies emerge. And so that's what you're going to do next on Tomtebo. Is that right? You're going to sort of get a little more modern now.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now I don't think I've ever been this excited to fly an airborne magnetic survey. It's a deep penetrating SkyTEM 312 HP, and it's never been done on the property, which is shocking because, you know, Garpenberg has mineralization from surface all the way down to 1600 meters. And this survey will allow us to see down to 500 meters or deeper. But the beauty of this is, I mean, we're not going to come out of the gate and be drilling 500 meter holes. Today's drill results showed, you know, high grade intercepts as shallow as 42 meters down. So, you know, we're going to start shallow and work our way down following the mineralization. And, you know, the intervals of, you know, around 5 meters, that's what they mine at Garpenberg and at Zinkgruvan. And, you know, then there's the hope that when you follow these high grade horizons down, they start folding, and where they hit zones of repetitive folding, they thicken up and they can get as wide as 20, 30 meters. So, and you actually have seen at the historic Tomtebo mine, on the historic records, the high grade copper that they mined out of there was in 20 meter seams. So, we know that magnitude is on the property. We just need to prove it up in other parts and get the tonnage along with that grade.
Well, super interesting historic drill data. It was great to read that and look forward to the next steps in the project as well, Garrett. Thanks very much. Great to see you. We'll talk soon.
Yeah, thanks, Steve. Talk soon. Bye.
All right, Garrett Ainsworth, the CEO of District Metals Corp.